Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm answering the question, how long will a facelift last? Now, a lot of people wonder, do I go minimally invasive? Should I go threads and fillers, neuromodulators, lasers? Or simply, why not just get a facelift and be done with it? That's what we're discussing. Is that right? What's the truth? What are the fallacies? We're going to dive into this Raji's Quick Clip in 3 seconds. Okay, so facelifts are quite popular. There's many done in the United States and around the world every year. And a lot of people are teetering and they're often wondering, one of the most questions that are asked on this channel is, why not just get a facelift? Why wouldn't I just get a fat transfer? Why would I even bother? Just wait till I'm 60 and then I'll do it all then. Those don't really pan out in terms of waiting. And the reason is this, a facelift, in general, there's deep plane, some people do superficial, but the real facelift that is going to last, that works well, involves what we call the SMAS, and that's a layer in the skin that helps, it's a fibrous layer, a continuum from the neck, musculature, up through the face, and it's what really gives and holds a lift if you talk to the purists. So the real facelift is done that way, by going down, getting the SMAS, taking the platysma band, which of course we target with neuromodulators like Botox, those pesky bands that people get, and actually placating it and removing part of it, tying it up. Whatever has to be done to tighten the neck. And then also people would say with a real facelift would include a brow lift. So it's an involved surgery. But imagine we'll tackle the first question there, which becomes, hey, why not just wait till the end? And part of talking about does this last forever, you have to understand, if that's what involved cutting back here and doing all those things, removing skin, moving the face and tightening it, what happens to the skin here, 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 here? And what about the volume and bone loss in the temple, in the cheek, the gaunt area that occurs in, we call the submalar area, the preauricular area that you always see me fill with Sculptra. What happens to those areas? Simply nothing. They get pulled. The dermis, the skin, the layers remain unchanged. So number one is they're two totally different things. If you get a facelift, you're better off going in with good skin, having taken care of your skin all along. If you get a facelift, you're better off taking care of it after. You're going to need, most people, you don't need anything, kind of a misnomer, but you're going to want to maintain that because it's a $30,000 to, I hear people now paying $150,000 to $200,000 really for a facelift. I mean, it exists, so you're going to maintain it. But even if you take away the maintenance of it, when you pull that skin back, an older face is older because of hollows. Yeah, you can lift the brow, but what if you have a hollow in the temple, a hollow here? What if you have loose skin, perioral lines, smoker's lines? The facelift doesn't address that other than tightening the skin. So, two different things. Now, to the question, how long does it last? In general, the first one will last 10 years, and after that, they last less, meaning they're not as effective. And much goes into that. I'm answering it because if I don't give you a direct answer, many people in the comments, and I love the comments, and I love that you share and like these videos, definitely share them. If you feel that people are going to be helped with these, send them to your friends. As we grow, I can do more and give you better information, more in-depth education, so share them. But a lot of people then say, hey, you didn't give the answer. 10 years the first one, and in general, 4 to 8 for the next one. And it decreases because typically the average age in the United States, say, is around 50, 52 for a facelift procedure. Now, you see people put on YouTube 30, 35 year olds getting facelifts, and people will ask, they'll say, hey, in the comments, how long will this last? And you'll see people answer, forever. Okay, let's dive into that real quick. Almost nothing lasts forever in life if it's good. Let me repeat it. Almost nothing in life will last forever if it's good. It takes work. Whether you love your car and you want that to last for your life, you gotta maintain it. You all know I drive 30, 40 year old cars. That's what I like. You gotta maintain those. So a marriage, a relationship, a partnership, a business partnership, if you like it, it's good. You better maintain it. If you don't like something, it could be permanent. So in the comments, I'm sure I'd love to hear what are the things, because I'm just ripping this off the top of my head, but you're probably going to come up with some things that are great that do last for life, but that's a generality. So you have to take care of things and you have to maintain. So let's say the 50-year-old gets a facelift, it lasts to 60. Now that's a generalization. The bone is going to change. Of course, you get bone remodeling. I have videos on that. The fat is going to change in the face. The fat pads become more demarcated. The fat pads decrease in size. Watch my videos on that. The muscle, some would maintain the muscle hyperstimulates then, overreacts because there's less support in the face. So all of those changes still occur over 10 years. And at 50, for a female especially, what's changing? Hormones. So if the hormones maintain, that may last longer. If the hormones don't, it may go quicker. So there's a lot of factors. Now, let's go into how it might last for life. So I'll maintain that, A, you need, if you have a facelift, you need to maintain it with biostimulators, lasers. And it's why, if you see a lot of surgeons after the facelift's done, while the patient's asleep, when peels were in fashion, the deep phenol peels, they might do a phenol peel, but CO2 laser, which I have a whole video on, was done or is often done on the table to stimulate collagen, thicken the dermis, make the skin get better, and have fine lines. Because it's very discouraging to have a facelift. I'm gonna round it off to 20 or 30 grand, okay? And in 6 months after all that recovery, come to the mirror and see fine lines, smoker's lines, they're still there. People think they're gonna go with a facelift. So the consult is key, but understand that will last, say, 10 years longer of maintenance. Now, could it be permanent? And here's why you can't really damn that statement fully. And the reason is you take twins, identical twins, same sun exposure, same hormones, same everything. They're both 50. They get a facelift. Okay, one at age 50 goes down to Vegas, partying every night, boozing it up, by the pool, sun exposure, not on any bioidentical hormones, whatever floats your boat. The other one eats healthy, eats antioxidants, goes to where I'm from, goes to Canada up north, doesn't hit the ski hills with the sun, but basically is indoor all the time, doesn't get the sun exposure. You're up in the cold, you know, the Russians drink a lot. When you're in the cold, the people do drink a lot, but we'll take the alcohol level down for the in the north person versus the Vegas person, okay? So healthy lifestyle, you get where I'm going. That twin that took care of their skin is going to look better than the one who didn't. They both had a facelift. There would be one that's going to last longer forever, maybe not. Let's take another scenario, because now you know about maintenance, and here's where it fits into maybe forever. Take those same two twins, put them in the same environment, and then at 50, one gets a facelift, one doesn't. Keep them in the same environment. Don't change anything. Now, the one who had the facelift at 60, a good facelift, is going to look younger than the one that didn't. So you might say it lasted forever. The result at 60, they're probably going to want something more done. They're not, and of course, life changes. At 60, many people might say, hey, I don't mind anymore. Come to terms with it. I'm living a different life. I'll just let it go. Don't let things go. You can maintain, you can do little stuff, you can do skincare, you can do sunscreen, whatever the maintenance is, but no need to let it go, okay? So you could say that those two people with the same demographics, the same exposures, did the one with the facelift will have a better result, a better look 10 years later, but it is not permanent per se. In short, think of 10 years, you know, everyone has their own opinion on this. When you start getting into the 30s doing facelifts, You should have exhausted all the minimally invasive options, in my opinion, there is. That's a very young age. In the 50s, if you're asking me my opinion, is appropriate. The aging, there's an aging rate, and we accelerate our aging rate at around 45, 55. So you're going to age quicker, at least seemingly, in those years, than from, say, 20 to 30, you're gonna age way less than 50 to 60 or 60 to 70. So you get the point. So much goes into it. That's about a facelift. Have you had one? Do you like it? Like this video, subscribe, stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.